Does like Emma's behavior ever worry you?
She can seem a little out of control from time to time, but she's smarter than people give her credit for. I think she's able to take good care of herself. She's a brilliant artist. Her sculptures are inventive and beautiful.
I like my paintings.
I know. Sometimes I'm in awe. They just don't seem to match her personality.
She's a deep person, but she hides it well. She's more comfortable being a ditzy teenager than a professional artist. But around the two of us, sometimes she lets the disguise drop. I love her when she does
that.
And
sleep with her for God's sake.
Do you like living in Venice?
I love Venice. I've been here 3 years now, and I haven't grown tired of it yet. I don't know if I ever will. Venice is like a college campus. There are so many young people here from all over the world. And the mix of nationalities and ideologies and ethnicities is refreshing and inspiring. The fact that we're also right in the middle of one of the great cities on Earth is just a bonus. Call Newport whatever you want. At least it's alive. And there's always something going on. Yeah, Venice is my kind of place. And I'm not planning on leaving anytime soon. At least not as long as all my friends are living here.
What about you, Charlie?
What about me?
Yeah? When was the last time you talked about yourself?
I don't talk about myself, girl. You know that.
Still, I'd like to talk about you for a bit.
If you want. Just in general, or is there anything in particular you want to
know? Oh, I don't know. Your biggest dream, for example.
What's your biggest dream?
A dark stage, a packed auditorium, and a single spotlight. Dancing, girl, don't you know? I'm a good dancer, but I need to be among the best to make it out in the real world. So I'll keep studying and I'll keep working as a waiter to support my studies, just like you.
Yeah, and also the dancing part kind of pointed to the transvestite. But anyway, no, I'm not judging. I mean, yeah. Yeah, he's clearly not a transvestite. He's just a gentleman, a good guy who likes to dance, and he also has a crush on April, I think. Next.
How did you end up in Venice?
At home, there wasn't much professional training available for dancers. And my father, he was not happy about my choice of career. He wanted me to work in the factories like him and his father. Out here in Venice, everyone's got their own dreams. And people are supportive of each other no matter how crazy those dreams might be.
Your dream isn't crazy at all, Charlie. You're already halfway there.
But I still have a long way to go. You're right, girl. I can make it if I work hard enough. So can you. Because we're both just so damn talented.
And a little bit psychotic. That kind of helps too.
Are you happy working here at the cafe?
We make decent money, if that's what you mean. I don't want to be a bartender for the rest of my life, obviously. But yeah, I'm happy I have a job. And you work here too, so I get to hang out with my friend, right?
If it wasn't for that, I don't know if I'd be able to do it. Hard work and lousy pay. The hours are flexible and, like you said, I get to hang out with you and my other friends. That's all I wanted to know, Charlie.
Okay.
Okay, bye.
Thanks, Charlie.
That's enough.
I have to get going, Charlie.
Take care, all right? Remember, you're supposed to get paid today. Stan's not gonna remember unless you bug him about it.
Let's go bug Charlie, and then bugger him.
Tom's Follies. Fresh bread. I love the food in this place. We have a great kitchen.
Let's take some bread. It will help us. Believe me.
It's a jukebox, according to Stan. It's an original. Almost 200 years old. I don't know. It looks like a replica to me. A good replica, but still...
Let's use it.
It took some convincing, but Stan finally agreed to put the jukebox on free play. I'll just choose a track at random.
smooth.
Roma Gallery presents Growing Pains, an exhibition by and for kids and teenagers. Could this be what Cortez was talking about? Where kids visualize their dreams? I think this may be it. Where's the Roma Gallery located? It's a poster ad for an exhibition called Growing Pains. I never say no to a complimentary ticket.
Never ever. Let's look at the ticket closer.
It's the address. The gallery's located near the Watertown Bridge. It's all the way over in West Venice, if I remember correctly. I'm gonna have to catch the Metro Line subway to get there.
And that's where the money comes in, because you have to get money from this guy. April's diary, let's see. Until you guys say if I should do this or not, I shall keep reading it. It turns out that Workers Visualize Their Dreams is an exhibition called Growing Pains at the Roma Gallery. That's down by the Watertown Bridge in West Venice. Too far to walk. I have to take the subway. It's an exhibition of work by inner city kids, and I guess the theme is dreams, which by some strange twist of fate is what everything's about today. So the Roma Gallery it is. Can't say I'm looking forward to it. Señor Cortez is just a little too creepy for comfort, but I'm in desperate need of some answers, so it's bye-bye to choice, hello destiny. Yeah. We play with destiny.
That's my... well... when she's not working, or out on a date, Emma's always hanging out here. Just like me, really. Just like all of us.
Let's speak with her. She may excellent conversation.
Settle this one for us, April. When did Roine Dale release Sidetracked?
2015.
04, right after the Morning Star exile, those sons of bitches.
With blood on their boots, yeah. Told you so, Marcus.
You said 03.
I was closer than you. 07, and you call yourself a fan.
I don't.
Did you speak with Zach today?
Yeah.
Why?
He was upset. Called you a stuck-up bitch.
He what? You gotta be kidding me. I wasn't even that rude to him.
You think so? So that even if you came crawling to his door, he wouldn't give you the time of day. Said you called him an asshole.
But he was listening?
Oh, God. I really don't know when to shut my mouth, do I?
Who cares? It's Zach. He hates you, so what? No great loss.
That's true.
So, what else is going on? What are you doing this afternoon?
Roma Gallery.
Actually, I came by to see if I could find Cortez.
What's with you and this guy? You'd rather spend time with him than us?
Never.
I have to find out what the message means.
Don't look at me. I don't know anything except what I already told you. Ask Charlie. He spoke with Cortez
earlier. Already did.
What are you doing?
Staying here. What else? I'm meeting a friend later, but that's not until 9. We're waiting for Isabel and then we're gonna eat. But I guess you're not hungry.
Nope.
No.
Figures. I don't know why I even bother asking.
Who's this friend you're meeting?
Bao Chikawawa?
Don't tell me. It's that guy you were out with last night.
Are you gonna tell me I shouldn't get involved with men like him?
No, of course not. I'm not your... You don't need me to tell you that, Emma.
Well, I wish you would, because you're right. I shouldn't. He's a bastard.
Yep.
But he's so cute and charming and, you know, very good in bed. I just can't help myself. But he's not a keeper. Don't worry about that. It's just this thing. Just a fling.
Okay, let's start the question marathon then.
Mind if I ask you some questions, Emma?
Like, I don't tell you everything that's going on anyway? Of course you can ask me questions. Like, duh.
Duh, April. What's wrong with you, gal?
What's your, take on Cortez?
My take on Cortez? What's that, like a diplomatic way of saying what the F is this guy's glitch?
Yep.
Sure. Let's go with that one.
You know, I think Cortez is a barrel of laughs. In a good way. Everybody thinks they got him all figured out, you know? Like he's the resident weirdo. But I know that just ain't true. I've talked with Cortez, and the guy is brilliant. He's weird, yeah, and he's up in the clouds, and I think he believes in aliens, which is cool, but girl, he's smart. I mean, I'm not talking professor smart here. I'm talking real life, seen it all, been there, done that, smart. Useful smart. Experienced smart. And, ooh, I gotta tell you, the guy's cultured. Ask him about anything, art, music, movies, books. He's current on most topics, which scares me, because it seems he's always just, I don't know, hanging around doing nothing. He rarely goes anywhere. And it's like he's waiting for something. Or someone.
Yeah, maybe Jerry Garcia.
You're bad. No, I don't think he's a doper. I mean, listen to the guy. What he says may sound a little out there, but the way he says it... No, he's not on Amethyn, that's for sure. And one more thing. He is cute.
He's what?
Cute.
Emma, he's like... 60?
Ah, so he's not over 100.
Did you ever see his eyes? Those are not the eyes of an old man. And so what if he's 60? He's better looking than most of the guys I date, and so much nicer.
Then I think you've been swimming in the shallow end of the gene pool for too long, Emma. I mean, come on, a 60-year-old screwball with a ponytail and an exotic accent? Hello?
Well, we'll see.
Did you speak with Charlie today?
Yeah, for a few minutes.
Why not?
Nothing. Just wondered is all.
April, did he say anything to you at all?
About what?
About... nothing. I mean, I don't know anything. Which isn't true because I don't lie, but he... Ugh, forget it. If we were having this conversation in a movie, I'd be going, like... Shit, girl, get your act together, open your eyes! But I don't think that's a good idea. Not in real life. Because real life has a nasty habit of hurting people's
feelings. As I've said, he has a crush on her.
Did you finish your sculpture for the exhibit?
Pretty much. I'm happy with it, and I know that if I go back and keep working on it, I'll just kill it. So I think I'll leave it alone. You?
You know what? Don't ask. I'm praying it'll finish itself one of these days.
Sure. Could happen. It could so happen. But I wouldn't count on it.
I'll have it ready in time.
Yes, you will, or I'll kick your ass so hard that you'll...
Okay, I got it! Thanks for the inspiration. Thanks, Emma.
Thanks for what? For talking to you? Girlfriend, what the hell is the matter with you? Snap out
snap,
of it!
Snap, snap. Okay, that's enough.
I gotta run.
See you around, stranger.
Bye-bye, you big booby bitch. Okay, now let's talk to Stanley.
My boss, Stan. A hard man with a soft... Nah. He's just a callous bastard.
I heard that.
I knew that.
I love this guy.
What you doing here? You ain't working this afternoon, are you? I don't want my employees work 24 hours a day. Go, get sleep.
But I'm just...
Damn, woman, do I have to babysit you?
It's nice to see you too, Stanley. No, I'm not working today. I just came by to...
Oh, don't ever say those two words when I'm around. I don't think my ulcer can
take it. Your ulcer...
You?
Your
nice?
Ulcer can just freak off.
That's funny. No, working... And not. Don't use those two words in the same sentence. Damn, I get creeps even when I say them.
I'd like to get paid.
I'd like to get paid.
Damn, woman, don't you know I got a migraine already? Paid? God damn it. Why'd they have to make that word sound so obscene? Listen, why don't you leave old Stan alone, huh? They make me feel a whole hell of a lot better. Choo, choo, be good, little girl. Hmm?
Screw off.
I'd still like to get paid, though.
Mighty mana, woman.
It's mana, you,
you really
bastard.
You know how to rub it in. God damn it. Yeah, all right. You got your timesheet?
Yep.
Yes?
Yes? Yes? Let's see it. God damn, you think I'm gonna take your word for a woman?
Okay, timesheet. Here it is. Here you go, you fat bastard.
here you are. My time.
You just took air.
Don't say that word too loud, sweetheart. You're killing me.
Killing you softly.
What is this? Huh? No. Did I sign this? What I think?
Oh god, she's hot.
So?
At least it doesn't look like it's been forged. Thanks.
Thanks?
Where's
my
money? Money!
Oh, you ain't getting it now. Next week, honey. I write down this amount in my ledger. Don't you worry your head from it.
Oh, don't be fucking cheap, you bastard.
I need the money now, Stanley.
Yeah.
Okay, okay.
Need money now. That ain't gonna happen. Next week, I tell you.
You lie.
Forget that. I quit.
You're quitting? You can't quit. You work for me. Nobody quits this job.
I do.
I can quit, and I'm quitting. I quit.
Damn, woman, you know how hard it is to find people to take a crappy job like this one? I need you.
Just as much as you need the money?
All right, Jesus, I give you your damn money. What was it, $50?
$375, Stanley, cash.
Oh, sure, cash. 300. Are you sure? I pay you guys way too much. Alright, give me your CC.
CC? Come right up. Oh, I didn't have to take it. I need to give it. Yay, I have cash. Whoop-de-doo.
Thank you, Stanley.
Fine, sure, whatever. Hey, just, I mean it. You free tonight? Wanna pull a shift? Sandra, she out sick and I need a replacement pronto. How about it?
Yep.
Yeah, I need the money.
Great, hon. I'll see you here later. Don't forget.
Velar Morgulis. Good. We shall read this final entry and then we shall end it for this first bit. I will split it up in 20-minute parts. And yeah, post it. Just a little reminder here, Emperor Ryan. You're working tonight. Don't forget, big remember sign. Stan will kick your butt if you don't show up on time. So there, apparently Sandra, that's well, the little girl I love so very, very much. She out sick again. Like, out back on those raptures already. Or not. I don't mind getting her paycheck. Alright. Well, guys, that's enough for today. See you next time with more parts. Goodbye.